Krebs cycle is known as Krebs cycle because it was described by Krebs. This cycle is also known as TCA cycle or tricarboxylic acid cycle because the product which is formed, that is citric acid, that citric acid contains three carboxylic groups. That is why this cycle is called tricarboxylic acid cycle. And this cycle is also known as citric acid cycle because first formed product is citric acid. So this we can start with pyruvic acid molecule. This pyruvic acid is formed as a result of glycolysis. And this pyruvic acid contains three carbon atoms. What happens? This pyruvic acid gets decarboxylated. It decarboxylates. That means it releases a molecule of CO2. And a two-carbon compound is formed. Coenzyme A molecule is also involved. And acetyl coenzyme A is formed. This acetyl coenzyme A is a two-carbon compound. Simultaneously, there occurs dehydrogenation. NAD is reduced to NADH. What happens? Enzyme involved is pyruvate decarboxylate. Now this acetyl coenzyme A enters citric acid cycle. This acetyl coenzyme A gets condensed with oxaloacetic acid. This oxaloacetic acid is a 4-carbon compound. When this acetyl coenzyme A condenses with oxaloacetic acid, a 6-carbon compound is formed which is called citric acid. This is 6-carbon compound. Since citric acid is first product, this cycle is also known as citric acid cycle. Now this citric acid is isomerized to form isocitric acid. And then this isocitric acid gets decarboxylated to form alpha-ketoglutaric acid. This, and in this process, NAD is reduced to NADH. This alpha-ketoglutaric acid again gets decarboxylated and forms succinyl coenzyme A. This succinyl coenzyme A is now, it forms succinic acid. This succinic acid, when this is formed, one GDP is phosphorylated to form GTP. This one GTP is equivalent to one ATP molecule. The succinic acid is then converted into fumaric acid. And in this process, FAD is reduced to FADH2. Then fumaric acid is now converted into malic acid, and malic acid then regenerates oxaloacetic acid. This is 4-carbon compound, this is again 4-carbon compound, this is 4-carbon compound, and this is 4-carbon compound. So in this also NAD is reduced to NADH. And if we see number of ATP molecules formed as a result of Krebs cycle, if we make ATP pool here, we can see one NADH molecule is equivalent to 3 ATP molecules. So 3 ATP molecules are generated from this side, and then in this process also, when there occurs decarboxylation, NAD is reduced to NADH. So this NAD is also equivalent, NADH is equivalent to 3 ATP molecules. And this GTP is equivalent to 1 ATP. 1 FADH2 molecule is equivalent to 2 ATP molecules. And this NADH leads to formation of 3 ATP molecules. So overall, in ATP in Krebs cycle, when one acetyl coenzyme A is entering Krebs cycle, there occurs formation of 12 ATP molecules. 12 ATP. And since breakdown of glucose forms 2 pyruvic acid molecules, so we can say there occurs entry of 2 acetyl coenzyme A molecules into mitochondria for this Krebs cycle. So we can say there occurs formation of 24 ATP molecules as a result of Krebs cycle. So we can calculate total number of ATP molecules. In glycolysis, there is net gain of 2 ATP molecules. And in Krebs cycle, 24 ATP molecules. And here also 2 NADH molecules are formed. So we can say during pyruvate decarboxylation, 6 ATP molecules are 2 into 3. 1 NADH is equivalent to 3. And 2 NADH are formed during pyruvate decarboxylation. Then 6 ATP molecules. So total gain of ATP is 32 ATP.